We're over in the Canalside Lounge with a very special guest. You may not know his name yet, but you will, because he was the number one trending person on iTunes a couple weeks back. He's a contestant on The Voice on Pharrell's team. His name is Luke Wade. Say hello, Luke.
Yeah. Hello, Luke.
Hello, yeah. Luke.
Hello, Luke Wade.
I don't know why I felt compelled to do the Princess Wade.
You should.
It was such a royal introduction. I couldn't help but just do this.
I get complimented on my introductions quite a bit.
Well, oh my God!
I think you're. I think you're. I need someone to introduce your introductions. That's
right.
How good they are.
Here's the special thing about you, Luke Wade. You were the very first contestant on this season of The Voice, the first one out of the gate. And I know in real life they edit that stuff up, so you weren't necessarily the first one to actually audition, but you're the first one they chose to show because they had to hook us in.
Right.
So that's a big honor for you.
Yeah, I felt so. I try not to overthink it because you have lots of time to overthink everything. Mm-hmm. I realized at some point during the season that I was like a really bad girlfriend to the Voice. And what I mean by that is like I read into everything that they did. Like, what
You're
is
paranoid?
That mean? What does that mean?
Like, why
what
am
do
I
you
first?
What do you like? I'm laying next to the show. I'm like, what are you thinking about The Voice? Like, what do you like? What is that? Like, you took me to dinner. What does that mean?
Were you texting and then erasing
I'm just. You know, I try not to think about, like, because it is a game, but I don't want to, I want it to be just music.
Right.
And so, trying to think about that, but it is a great honor, for sure.
Yeah, they started strong and all four turned around for you.
Who were you most hoping for? If you had to have chosen, I think Pharrell's the coolest, that's how it ended up going, but if only one turned around, who would you have preferred?
You know, the way I thought about it was I researched them all. Like, I knew a lot about them, but I wanted to kind of familiarize myself to the point where I felt like I knew them, like interviews, all kinds of things. And I wanted whoever wanted me the most, really.
Yeah.
I had an idea of who might want me the most and who might have the, who might approach the show the way that I would like them to.
And I would think that would be Blake, right? You're a guy with a guitar,
but
Blake
he's
Shelton.
Soulful.
You know, I haven't picked up a guitar on the show yet.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, here you are with it.
But I am a guy with a guitar. Yeah. So I like Blake's attitude. He seems like somebody that I could you know, vibe with and banter with.
And drink a beer with. That's I'm dying to drink a beer with Blake Shelton.
He would be like the number one person in the world to drink a beer with, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
Is he drinking when he's sitting there?
Because he sounds like it.
I won't confirm or
deny
that.
What's in the cup?
I mean, he says he is, but I was
I'll just say that it's a good thing you can't smell vodka through your television.
There you go. We're talking with Luke Wade, who's a contestant on The Voice. He's on Pharrell's team. Does it throw you off when you're in the middle of your performance and then all of a sudden you hear the and people are turning around and...
Or do you hear that, or they add those sound effects later, you know?
I'll just say that I was so into my performance. I had a game plan, and I was going to do it, and I was going to perform it. And I didn't know how I was going to react to the judges and the coaches. So I didn't want that to be a factor. So I knew exactly what I was going to do, and I wasn't going to let anything change it, whether they turned around or whether they didn't turn around, because, like, ultimately – that doesn't matter. Like, what matters is how well you do and just putting everything you have out there. And so I did that and I didn't even really know. I saw a light and I was like, that was probably someone turning around. And then I got done. I looked and they're all looking at me and I wasn't sure if they had turned before or after I was done. But
are you really in the zone?
I want somebody like super fan during one of those where they turn around and they just go, what's the party? You know, that's what I want.
That's one of the things they tell you is don't stop singing, because that actually has happened. They've
had
contestants that whenever a coach turned around, they just stopped singing in the middle of their song. They're like, don't
do that.
You can smile, you can laugh, like, but don't stop singing.
And I know you can't reveal anything about what's to come on The Voice for you, but you are on Pharrell's team. Have you already done some filming with him and had a chance to do all this one-on-one coaching?
I'll say that I've spent some time with him, and he is genuinely just a great guy.
Isn't he nice?
He's so nice.
And he's so amazing in engaging you in the moment and just being present. And listen, like absorbing you, and taking you in, and then kind of reflecting you back to you. Like it's really uncanny his ability to just to see you like in the moment as you are, and not and not kind of project his idea of who you are or anything like that. It's just he's constantly just in the moment, and it's amazing.
Now stop me if I ask you something you can't answer.
Yeah.
I know Gwen Stefani brought in her husband Gavin Rossdale to help her mentor. Who did Pharrell bring in, or can you say?
I can say that it was released on the news that it was a few months ago that he brought in Alicia Keys.
Okay.
So that's true.
I missed that.
Yeah.
Was it what he said that sold you to Pharrell when he said, you can ask Justin, you can ask Robin, I know what to do with that voice? Was that the moment you said?
The moment was whenever he said that I want to show America who Luke Wade is. Because I realized a long time ago in my career that there's nothing that you can do better than everyone else except for be yourself. And so I'm not going to try to be the best singer, you know, because you just can't, no one's the best singer. Like, all you can do is combine everything you have into being the best version of yourself. And so whenever he said, I want to show America who Luke Wade is, that's what that means to me. And I think that robots don't watch television, human beings watch television. And if you want to get people to connect with you, find someone who's going to help you be a human and not be like a song singing machine, you know? And so then that's what I want to do. And if I make it to the end or if I get kicked off, I want it to be on my terms and I want it to be as representing me as a person.
Because inspirational.
Well,
you are. That's great.
Thank you. You know, that's.
I'm going to try to be the best Luke Wade I can be, too.
Me, too.
I've been working at it a lot longer than you guys have.
Yeah, that's true.
You might be able to be the best Luke Wade, but there's a learning curve. Mm. There's a lot of, it was a bumpy road. So just be prepared for that.
That's why you're number one trending on iTunes a couple weeks back. That's great.
I don't even know how that works.
I don't either, but you were.
Well, they were selling all of the songs that the contestants sang. And
yeah,
so
absolutely.
I guess that means you beat everybody else. I guess that's what it means.
Well, there's the charts, and I wasn't the highest charting. I was of all the blinds that have gone so far, I think I'm a number three or four or something. But then I was number one trending, and so maybe they
the curiosity factor. Who is this Luke Wade?
Yeah, maybe they went on there, and maybe they and because I have my own albums, maybe it kind of split.
Mm-hmm.
They went and they bought enough of my stuff to I don't know. But it's awesome.
Yeah, it's good to put on your resume.
Yeah.
Yeah.
When do you realize that you can sing like that? Because we all sound different in our heads. You know, we can sing in the shower.
We all think we sound great, except for Jenna. She knows the truth.
Yeah, she knows the truth.
I'm terrible.
But we all think we're good enough. We could do that.
Well, no.
When was that moment where you finally, somebody told you, dang, Luke, I think you could do this for a living?
And really, there wasn't a moment. Doing something really well is... As I'm sure you guys all know, as being really talented people,
we don't know. That's
it's
the
not,
problem.
No, but you're everything.
Other
you're talented. Yeah, I don't know
things.
If you can sing, but you're really good at what you do and interviewing and engaging people and entertaining people. So it's a journey. It's not a destination. And so it really I felt that I had a message and I wanted people to listen to it. And so I started singing, and less people started leaving. That's kind of how it started. And then there was a point whenever I realized that I can say anything I want if I can figure out how to connect it to emotion. And that's singing. And so I just kind of, that was 4 years ago whenever I turned the biggest corner to get here.
Yeah.
But it was, you know, it's been 10 years of just failing in front of people and learning from my mistakes and then going back out and then going back out after every time that it doesn't work out the way that I thought it was going to work out. And then, so that's just, there was no, that's a common misconception in everything is that if you want to get somewhere, you have to start moving that way. And you have to accept the fact that there's no, there's no end point. It's just, you're always going to do it. And it's hard work and you have to do it because you love doing it, not because you want to get somewhere.
And plus you got to pay the rent.
How much say do you have, because you have all these originals, but on The Voice you do covers.
Mm-hmm.
And I know you're going to do a cover for us. Mm-hmm. How much say do you have in song choice on The Voice and what you get to perform?
You get a choice. You're definitely, they want you to do the best that you can do. And so they will guide you and help you not maybe make mistakes that you would inherently want to make because they hopefully, but they know the show and they know their audience. And so it's a collaborative effort.
Yeah, a lot of songs can be hits on the radio, but for a singing competition, it's not dynamic enough.
Right.
It doesn't show off enough range.
Mm-hmm.
So it might have been a number one hit for an artist, but for you, it caused you to lose the competition.
Yeah.
JC's teaching himself to play the guitar.
I'm self-taught. I suck.
Awesome, man.
Are you self-taught?
Well, it just kind of started out hanging out with myself. You know, and that's the cool thing about being a kid is that, you want to be around people, but it's really important to spend time, more time than you really want to, with yourself. So you can kind of, because you don't even know you yet. And so I feel like that's been something that was awesome for me, is like playing the guitar. I would just stay at home and just play it for 5 hours at a time.
Wow.
And I had a couple of lessons, and I had a little Shih Tzu.
Uh-huh.
That would just—
No cursing on the radio, please.
Oh,
no, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, I don't know, man. I didn't realize. I didn't mean to hurt you. but she was deaf, and so she would just like hang out on me like this all day, and I just hung out with my Shih Tzu and played guitar.
There's nothing better than when you finally hit a note and it sounds right when you strum it on the guitar. You know,
it does feel good.
That's a sad story. You should have told that on The Voice. Yeah. You hung out with your deaf Shih Tzu all day in your room alone and play guitar. Because everybody has to have a sob story.
Yeah. Is that sad? That actually sounds awesome.
My deaf Shih Tzu.
No, it's not sad. It's sweet. It is sad. Charming. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
That sounds like a song. My poor deaf Shih Tzu.
That's a country song.
She had a really, like, she couldn't hear her bark. And so it was a very interesting.
What did her bark sound like, if you don't mind me asking?
I don't know if it'll be offensive to other deaf dogs.
To deaf dogs?
Right.
Well, they won't hear you. So
dude, we're number one with deaf dogs.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Okay. It was like a...
Like a duck?
Yeah. That's pretty much, yeah. I used to date her. Yeah.
Where can they find out about you? You have like LukeWryan.com. Luke Wade.
No problem. No problem.
I'm sure that doesn't ever happen.
I'm a little less trucks and spring break.
Yeah, right. Sorry.
But you still like girls shaking it for
yeah,
you.
Yeah, but I mean, but I kick it. LukeWadeMusic.com.
LukeWadeMusic.com. Okay. Yeah.
And also LukeWadeMusic on Twitter and Instagram, right?
That's right.
And of course, watch The Voice tonight. It's exciting. You're sitting back pretty right now because you've already made it in this blind audition part. We're just waiting for the battle rounds. We're excited about that.
Yeah. Well, I mean, and they often surprise you about what they'll show you during an episode. So
okay.
Maybe I'll pop in. Maybe I won't. We'll see.
Yeah. You never know.
You never know.
Make sure you watch The Voice. And keep up with our boy Luke Wade. And keep it going, Luke.
I know, he's so chill. Yeah. JC, I wish you'd dress like this too. He has great style.
I know he does.
But you do so great practicing your intros. You need to work on your outro.
Yeah, my outro game.
I was going to say the same thing. Your outro-ductions are not nearly as good.
Okay.
As
okay. All right, hold on. Here, do a redo. Okay.
Redo.
Okay. Right, so thanks so much for joining us, Luke Wade. And here's JC to
say goodbye.
Outroduce.
And keep up with Luke Wade on Twitter. And stuff.
That was even worse.
I feel like you're like a baby bird with a wounded, wing, and I need to hold you and nurse you back to health.
He wants to pet you.
Everybody, give it up for Luke Wade.
Yeah. Yay.